Okay, so each generation, the technology to really do anything is becoming more and more accessible, which I think is beautiful, because now we're able to hear stories from voices from people who never had access to like an animation studio and under no supervision or direct guidance by an instructor, mentor. Daytime Noir was sort of inspired by just the exploitative nature of daytime television.
That ain't my baby. Who baby is?
It's the type of show where they're doing paternity tests. Kids have boyfriends or girlfriends that are like 20 and they smoke cigarettes and they're cursing and everybody's booing these kids. But I'm like, this is like a child, you know what I'm saying? If anything, this is a cry for help. We shouldn't be booing this kid. They need help. It's just many layers of exploitation. Just the darker side of it. You know, I just came with Daytime Noir.
Yeah, that can't be my baby.
Originally, Daytime Noir was going to be in a longer form series called Stank Burger, but Stank Burger wasn't really developed fully when I met with FX. But I mean, I showed it to them. They were really interested in the shows within the show, so there was just going to be a lot of daytime TV and advertisements. Daytime Noir starts in a fast food joint called Stank Burger, and it's focused on a mother and a child, Tanya Jackson and Demetrius. Demetrius is waiting for his dad to come pick him up, but it seems like he might not come. My parents were divorced, so there was a lot of time I've spent just waiting on another parent to come get me, like, in just these weird sort of purgatories in these fast food restaurants.
Y'all gotta work something out, but we not gonna, if you come up here, we not gonna be up here, so whatever.
These sort of conversations I've heard over and over and over again, you know, like as a kid, if you're just in a fast food restaurant or just a restaurant, you know, you're just gonna like watch the TV and it's usually just daytime TV. They're sitting there and they see the ad.
Is your son dressing a little too sexy? Is your auntie too big to work the twerk? Have you been physically assaulted or nearly blinded by your nephew? If so, call the Moore Show to tell your story.
And, you know, get on this conversation with this slimy producer type character.
As the saying goes, if the shoe fits, am I right?
And Ty's just like, all right, whatever. I mean, we'll do whatever. We kind of just need this money.
We're going to fly you out for an audition.
Thanks.
A mom exploiting their child, production exploiting the whole family, just like flying these people out to get a taste of this lifestyle and get some money just to make fun of them, exploiting them and exploiting their misfortune and really not addressing the situation.
What should I say?
I wanted to show that this is like a good kid with passions and talents, but just due to the situation they're in, you know, he kind of just gets scolded a little bit for just wanting, I guess, attention or validation.
Look at this boy here. Lord have mercy. Look at Delroy. Look at this boy here. He needs to tell his mom to get him some new planning pants. It's too damn small.
They call him like a bad kid and they talked about him like he's a bad kid. You know, I for the most part, I don't think there's really a such thing as like a bad kid. Maybe their parents are divorced or come from an unstable home, or they just feel they're not getting the love they desire. They may act in a way to get attention. Even if it is like negative attention, they just want some attention. They want to be appreciated. They want to be validated. You know, especially in the Black community, people are so quick to be like, oh, so-and-so has ADHD or this mental illness and da 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 needs to be held back or has to go to these remedial classes and things of that sort, or they act out and they call the police and they get arrested at school. I think they're just kids that are misunderstood.
you, mommy.
A panhandler may have fallen on misfortune, but you, however, might have fallen victim to this man's fortune.
I was living in New York at the time. Homelessness was like a big problem. You know, this guy, he was definitely exaggerated. People see him come on and they just like get annoyed. It was just another situation I'd seen where it's like, okay, this person needs help and we're just making fun.
Okay, okay, easy, easy, guys.
This is really different for me to do, and like narrative and comedy are very new and we're kind of challenging, and the subject matter was kind of challenging. I don't want to get too deep in the meaning behind it, 'cause I want other people to kind of come with their own opinions, but I didn't want to just come out and say like, hey, homelessness is a problem, we need to do something about it. So, you know, I decided to do that with humor and in a joking way. It's just more of an outlet, you know?
Anything helps. Money, food, water. Ladies, if you are pregnant and or lactating, I am accepting donations in the form of breast milk.
Which, you know, some people may find, you know, aren't you just making fun of a homeless person or things of that sort? That's the kind of questions I'm trying to get people to ask and to be like, you know, like maybe they laugh, maybe they don't, I don't know. Just to get the conversation started. And, you know, that's what I'll continue to do.
If I'm unable to procure means through which to feed myself and my son, I will be forced to eat my son.
That's definitely been something I've been talking about. And, you know, unfortunately, early on in my career, that sort of overt political imagery and messages were not well received, especially on a very, like, commercial space. And, it, you know, people were, they liked my work, they liked my style. But when it came to, like, the political element, that would kind of, like, turn them off.
I repeat, I do not want to eat my son.
First and foremost, I always want to create for myself. If it goes to festivals or it gets picked up on television, I always want to create something that I personally like and that I want to see. And I think my stuff has such conceptual vigor because I'm just genuinely interested in conceptual art. In my free time, I'm the type of dude that'll go to an art museum. My work sort of teeters on this line of commercial, television, movies sort of art, and fine art, video art, sort of conceptual art. I'm very inspired by a lot of Black artists like Kehinde Wiley and Kerry James Marshall. One painting in particular of his was the barbershop painting. So in my barbershop scene, I pretty much had an image of Kerry James Marshall's barbershop, and I like developed mine and was like in direct reference to his style. At moments, it can be very detailed, and then at other moments, it can be more stylized and abstract. So that's definitely a constant source of inspiration for me. I do that a lot in my work, just like look at an art piece. A lot of my films like Glucose and Octane, both were really inspired by Basquiat. There's just some social cues that are pretty triggering. I mean, not always in a negative way, but like it just triggers emotions. And you know, you just get somewhat of a visceral response, like looking. It's also very challenging.
The exploitative nature of this show catapulted me into the superficial and fickle world of celebrity, wherein I've simply become a parody of myself. However, I did receive the love and affection that I so desperately sought from my loved ones.
Obviously, Black people have been exploited for labor and a plethora of reasons in America. But one in recent history has just been, you know, exploited in the media. And it's a weird space. It's a really challenging space. And it was really challenging for me to create some of these things. It's not just a Black and white situation. Exploitation isn't just, you know, oh, white people exploiting Black people, you know, and it's a whole system that is just like, here's a potential opportunity, and it's kind of weird, but I'm gonna take it.
You did real good, baby. My baby about to be a star.
You know, I'm going to make my child do this. Whoop-de-wop. I really wanted to challenge viewers to think critically about, you know, what they're consuming, especially nowadays with social media. It's so easy for Black people to share their culture with one another, but also for non-Black people to also share in that. It feels very strange because a lot of people, they love Black culture. You know, when I was growing up, people weren't really talking about politics like this. This stuff is very in vogue right now. The Black Lives Matter movement and activism and politics. And really just, I hope that it helps, you know, kind of unify people and show that, you know, we're all more alike than different.